It's Gabby here from Ray Studios, and today I'm gonna be reviewing the Meepo Mini 2. Meepo have sent me the Mini 2 for review and for an upcoming video that I'm gonna be doing very soon, in which I'm gonna be comparing the best electric shortboards ever, or at least in 2021. First, let's do a quick unboxing. Everything comes nicely packed. As soon as you open the box, there is a quick guide printed directly on the box. Immediately we can see a warning and instruction manual, the classic Meepo stickers, a few Allen wrenches, and the classic T2. We also have a wristband, spare parts, the charging brick and the charging cable, the charging cable for the remote and the remote itself. And of course, you also have the Mini 2. So here we have it, the Meepo Mini 2. First, let's talk about the design. I like what they did here with the dark gray and the black and the orange. We can see that there are a lot of screws visible right there. We have the screws for the tracks, for the battery, for the AC. So they're all kind of visible. They could have done that under the grip tape. Talking about the grip tape, it's extremely grippy, a bit too much for my taste. And the problem that I have with that is that in my heart, the skin on my hands when I'm grabbing this ball, and also when I carry the ball from the tracks, that could like break my pants a little bit. So I think it's not really that necessary to be that grippy, but that's my own personal preference. You might ride very aggressively and you want this sandpaper to be ultra grippy. Now, when we turn it around, we can see that they're really putting some work in this board. So this is painted and it feels good to the touch and looks really nice. So it's in this combination of like petrol, gray, green, black, dark gray. Looks really nice. I gotta say, I like it. I like the orange in the cover. So it reflects what we see on the grip tape. They have this like black, dark gray and orange, and they make it work. I think it looks really good. We also have here a battery indicator. That's something that you don't get with most boards. So this is a 90% at the moment. And you can see it just from the board. You don't need to turn it on and see with the remote. Let me turn that off. Let's uncover this port. And we have a charging port right there. But we also have a USB so you can charge your phone. That's very nice. There are many boards nowadays that they come with that. The problem with this is not that easy to close again. Kinda. I don't know. After a few tries, I got it close. Now, the wheels are 90mm wheels with a 70AA durometer. That means they're soft and very nice and grippy, especially for an electric shortboard. But the one thing that kind of worries me a little bit is this, the hub motors. So there is very thin layer of PU around these hub motors. And I want to remark something here. These are not hobby wing motors because this doesn't have a hobby wing ESC. And I remark this because hobby wing motors, there are some wheels called the Cloud Wheels 105mm Discovery Donuts that you can mount into these hub motors, but not into these ones. So you're basically, if I'm not mistaken, you're stuck with this thin layer of PU around these motors. So I guess it's time for me to go out there and test how this perform and how these motors with this thin PU will feel like.
Hey guys, I've been riding the Nippon Mini 2 for a couple of days, and I gotta say, I'm quite surprised, especially with two things. First, the ESC. So this have the Link-E ESC that is especially customized from Nippon. And if you know anything about electric skateboards, you know that there are basically two ESC. One is the Link-E, another one is the Hobbywing, at least when it comes to commercial electric skateboards. And the Hobbywing tends to be the one that is smoother, especially for accelerating and braking. So it feels good while riding. Well, that changed. The Link-E ESC is now very smooth. There is no more any jerkiness feel, like you're riding, you don't feel any push or sudden brakes. It feels pretty good and it's very, very responsive. And they have the advantages of the Link-E ESC, which is when you're on an incline, if you hold the brake, the board stays there. With a Hobbywing ESC, with a Hobbywing electric skateboard ESC, if you hold the brake and you're on an incline, it will still moving. And it's a horrible feeling in places like where I live that I'm surrounded by mountains. So when this one breaks, stay break, which is really cool. Another great thing that surprised me about this board is, like, you can see here the hub motors have a very, very slim PU sleeve. So the sleeve for the hub motors is just so thin. And I was expecting to have a very rough ride. That didn't happen. I feel quite comfortable with this. It's just like any other hub motors, basically. So this is thinner, the sleeves are thinner than any other hub motors, but the comfort was the same like any other that have much thicker sleeve. So yeah, that was quite good. Actually, the wheels are quite soft and grippy. It felt pretty good. One thing that I'm still concerned a little bit is what will happen after riding, I don't know, 6 months or 1 year. How long will this sleeve last? Like, I know my X-Way X1 Pro that also have hub motors, the sleeves are thicker than this, and I have to replace them, like, I don't know, like every 6 months or so. So if you have a Nippon Mini 2, let me know in the comment section down below for how long you have it and how long do these sleeves lasted on your board. Now, let's talk about the riding experience, and it feels really good. I think this board is almost like a Lombo, but a bit shorter. It's very powerful. The deck is very roomy. It felt really comfortable riding. It's also very stable at high speed. It's kind of like a sporty electric shortboard. That's one way to put it. It have a kicktail, so you can also, you know, enjoy that advantage of being a shortboard with a kicktail, so you can turn in some tight places. The tracks, they look like they're very well built, very strong, but I gotta say, it wasn't the best carving experience ever. It wasn't bad either. Another thing that I want to remark is that the battery indicator, both here on the battery case and on the remote, quite inaccurate. Like, sometimes it will jump from 2 bars to blinking 1 bar or 3 bars to 2 bars. It's like, it's hard to tell how much battery there is left on this cable. And because I ride in places where there are, like I say, I live surrounded by mountains, as you are climbing, you will use a lot of battery. So yeah, it terrifies me when I start blinking in 1 bar and then I turn it off. And when I turn on again, it's on 2 bars or 3 bars. So quite inaccurate on the battery indicator, all right? So generally speaking, I would say that it performs so good. I'm gonna put this down. It's a little bit heavier than other electric shortboards. By the way, if you wanna see this Nippon Mini 2 compared with some of the best electric shortboards in the market, make sure to subscribe to the channel, because I'm planning to do a video comparing this to all the other electric shortboards that are in the market today. It's a huge video that is taking me so much work, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you enjoyed this review, don't forget to give it a like. There are gonna be links in the description down below in case you wanna buy the Mini 2, possibly with some discount, so make sure to check that out. And yeah, have you subscribed already? If not, do it right now. Yeah, right now. And I'll catch you up on the next video.